Hello friends, in the previous video of the French Revolution, CBSE Standard 9, we saw the storming of Bastille, the reason that riots were there in the city, and King called the army in the city. And we also saw the impact of and significance of storming of Bastille. And now we need to see what reason or what were the factors which actually caused the storming of Bastille. Storming of Bastille was not an event that took place overnight. It has a long years of background. So we started to see the background also. The background started from the Louis XVI became the king of France, found the empty treasury, various reason for the empty treasury, then division of the French society into three estates, clergy, nobility, and the third estate, commoners. Then we saw the subsistence crisis, and we also saw the work of the philosophers. Yes, that was the background. Now, exactly we'll start which event which started a chain action or chain reaction which ultimately ended into the storming of Bastille. So let's move on now. Outbreak of the revolution, how revolution exactly started, of which storming of Bastille was an important event. So the event started from the king's wish to impose a new tax. We saw that the king's treasury of King Louis XVI's treasury was empty and he wanted money. And the easiest way to earn money is to impose a new tax. Obviously, he wanted to impose a new tax, correct? But there was a procedure to impose a new tax. Of course, the procedure was not compulsory for the king to follow. But there was a procedure which king, if wish, could follow. And that was the procedure of king had to take approval from a state general. King had to take the approval from the state general. Now the question is, what was a state general, right? We'll get this answer immediately, don't worry about it. Earlier kings, like Louis XVI's father or the grandfather, did not give that much importance to the state general. Actually, you can see here, the last meeting of the Estates General was called in 1614, and now we are studying about the 1789. I think it goes approximately 175 years, 74-75 years somewhere. The last meeting of the Estates General was conducted. It means it was up to the king whether to call the meeting of Estates General or not, right? So king decided to call the meeting of Estates General because it was a part of the procedure. If the king wanted to impose a new tax or increase the existing tax, he needed the approval of the Estates General, though it was not compulsory. So let's see what was Estates General. Firstly, what was the composition of Estates General? Estates General was the assembly where the representatives of all the three states were present. There were three states, we saw clergy, nobility, and the commoners. And to the meeting of Estates General, clergy used to send 300 representatives, they selected among themselves. Nobility also sent 300 representatives, and commoners 600. Of course, the commoners were the almost 90% population, so they sent 600 representatives. And the assembly of all the three representatives of all the three states was called as Estates General, Assembly of Estates General. So it was used to get approval. King would offer them a proposal and these three states had to say yes or no. So, and each state had one vote. Each state had one vote means the 300 representatives of clergy, they meet together, they'll think about the king's proposal, and as a whole, single state, they decide whether yes or no. All the 300 people vote, would not vote separately. Same was the case with nobility. All the 300 people would come together and decide whether to say yes or no, and same was with third estate. But this time the situation was different as 1614. This time, though there were three states and only three votes, but members of the third estate were more educated and rich. And we saw that the three philosophers like Rousseau, Montesquieu, John Locke, they had already written their books, which were widely read by the common people, and their minds were also expanded, the mental horizons expanded. And though there were only 600 representatives came from the third estate, but they carried 40,000 letters. It means they represented directly 40,000 people. Okay, that was, and the Louis XVI was the head of the meeting. So the meeting was called. When was the meeting of a state general called? The meeting of a state general was called on the 5th May 1789. Okay, we saw 300, 300 and 600. The king was sitting in the center, you can see here. The clergy were sitting here, 300 clergy. Here you find the 300 nobles, 300 clergy, and 600 people of third estate were standing behind all these people, and the king was sitting in the center. So traditionally the voting system was that each state had one vote, so all the three states had three votes, estate general had three votes. But this time third estate came with a different mentality. Third estate demanded each person one vote, so they wanted 1200 votes in the assembly. But do you think the king would accept this demand? No, he would never accept this demand, because king was sure that if he proposes to impose a new tax, and as we have already seen, clergy and nobility were exempted from all the paying all the taxes, of course they wouldn't have any problem with imposing a new tax. So they would have approved the king's proposal, and third estate was surely refused because they already had a huge burden of taxes and they did not want any more tax. But third estate versus first and the third second estate, so king's proposal would surely be passed. That the king was highly assured. So since 5th May, third estate were demanding for one person one vote, and king could not accept it. So king kept on rejecting, so there was a deadlock. And finally, when the people of the third estate convinced that king was not going to give them one person one vote, so all of them on 20th of June, I think, yes, 20th of June 1789, all the 600 representatives were angry and walked out, left the hall where the meeting of the estate general was being conducted. They left the hall, they came out of the hall and directly entered a tennis court, which was also a part of the Palace of Versailles, where the meeting was being held, the king's residence. They left the assembly hall and entered the tennis court. So see, you can see all the 600 people, what did they do? Walked out from the assembly hall. And where did they go? They went to the tennis court. And what they were thinking about themselves? They thought that we, the 600 people, were chosen by 90% of the population. So as a result, we are the true representatives of the French people. The clergy and nobility, though they are together 600, but they represented hardly 10%. And we 600 represent 90% population. So we are the true representatives. And so when all these 600 people gathered in the tennis court, first of all, they declared themselves National Assembly. Remember, they read the books of Montesquieu, Rousseau and John Locke. So they declared themselves the National Assembly, the representative of the entire population of France. And they took the oath. What was the oath? That they will not disperse from the tennis court till they draft a constitution for France. Jab tak France ke liye constitution draft na kar le, tab tak wo indoor tennis court chhod ke bahar nahi jayenge. And what feature they wanted to give to the constitution, or you can say, what was the purpose? The purpose of the constitution was to limit the powers of the king. It means to convert the absolute monarchy in France into a constitutional monarchy. So you can see the image, they were taking oath. Okay, there was a twist. Those who walked out of the meeting of the estate general, they were not 600, they were few more than 600. See, again, the mistakenly, there was some technical error, the same images came. Mirabeau and Abbesses, they did not belong to the third estate. Mirabeau belonged to the second estate. He was a noble by birth. And Abbesses, he was a priest, he was clergy. So these people, though they did not belong to third estate, but they seems that they were good men at heart. So Mirabeau wanted to destroy the society based on division, like old regime, clergy, nobility, commoners. He did not want that. He wanted a single society where all should be equal. And he also wrote extensively, published his own journal in support of the third estate. And meeting of the estate general, he delivered so powerful speeches that the people were inspired and motivated. Abbesses, though he was a priest, but ideas were almost similar with Mirabeau, did not want the society, divided society. And he also did extensive writing, but this work, What is the Third Estate, is a very famous. So these people were very good people, maybe at heart. So they went against their own communities, against their own estates, and had the Third Estate, and played an important role in that too. So see, what was happening? After 20th of June 1789, the 600 representatives of the Third Estate were locked in the inside the tennis court, declared themselves the National Assembly, and took up the work on the shoulder, which worked to draft the constitution for France. And which constitution, which kind of constitution? Such a constitution which would limit the powers of the king. It was a very hot temperature in the Palace of Versailles now. King was, would have been angry, and these people also. So it was very difficult situation. But it was not only the inside the tennis court or inside the Palace of Versailles, there was a heat. The heat was also in the rural France as well as the urban France also. Let us see the urban France case now. Urban areas. Remember what we studied in the previous section, subsistence crisis, not availability of food, and the people were started to die due to unavailability of food. That is subsistence crisis, and the year 1789 was one such unfortunate year. There was extreme winter this year 1789, and there was a shortage of food. And as a shortage of food, price increased because the demand was high and the supply was less. And when the prices increased, the bakers, those who sold the food grain, they hoarded, they collected food grain with them so that they can sell later when the prices will be even more high. They wanted to earn more profit. But now people lost their control, common people. How a mother could see her children dying of starvation when she knew that the food was kept in the shop? So women started, of course the men were also with them, broke out the shops and started to take the food, steal the food. And the riots started, and the shopkeepers wanted to protect their food grain. So riots started, and it was total violence on the streets. So the king called the soldiers in the city of Paris to bring the situation under control. And remember that when people were hungry, dying of starvation, it was king's duty to supply them food. Rather than supplying the food, king called the army to maintain peace. People got angry. They thought that maybe they might have thought we are going to die by the way, so why not fight and die then? So people also did what we already studied, storming of Bastille. That was happening in urban areas. Let's see what's happening in rural areas. Do you think that all this thing was happening in urban areas? So rural areas were calm and silent? No. The situation was even more terrible in rural areas. How? See, there was a hierarchy in the French administration. The king was at the top of the hierarchy. There were some dukes, there were some manors, there's some, like in our India also, prime minister, then the chief minister, then the district collector, commissioners, then the district collectors. In the same way, in rural areas, there were some people who were the representatives of the king. They were called lords, dukes, and manor lords of the manors. And rural people, they got the rumor, again the rumor, that lords of the manors appointed brigands. The brigands means contracted people. And what contract they got to those brigands? To destroy the standing crops of the poor people, to revenge them, because the people were against the king. So revenge those people, the representatives of the kings, sending appointed contracted people to destroy the standing crops which was ready, and the people could not bear. There was already a shortage, and if the standing crop is destroyed, how people would accept? So before the brigands, gunde, isse pehle ki lords of the manors ke, dukes ke gunde aake hamari fasal barbaad kar de, people took their weapons. Farmers, which kind of weapons the farmers could have? They got this hose. They can have the pitchforks. They took the hose and pitchforks and attacked the chitoks, the houses of the palaces, small palaces of the dukes and lords of the houses of the manor houses. They destroyed them, burned them. Whatever food grain was stored in these big palaces, small palaces, they confiscated them. And also all the records of taxes were also burnt. And even more than that, they started killing the nobles, relatives of the kings, maybe kings, confidential people, supporters, friends, common people, started to kill them. And these people, these nobles, had to run away out of France to save their lives. It was even more serious thing. Now, French Constitution drafted. And what was happening? We saw before what happening in rural and urban areas. We saw now, but before that we knew that National Assembly was busy in the drafting constitution, and King of course did not want to accept that constitution, but the situation which was happening outside, riots in urban areas, rural areas, and King was knowing that his own supporters who were living in dukes and manors, they left their country, most of them died, and those who did not die, they survived because they ran out of the country. That created a huge pressure over the king, and king surrendered, and king accepted that yes, whatever constitution you people, the 600 representative third estate, you make, I will accept that constitution. So the king recognized the National Assembly, yes, you 600 people are the true representatives of the people, and you are the National Assembly. King accepted that. King also approved the constitution drafted by these people. King said, okay, your constitution is right, and I will work according to that constitution. And what was the feature? The constitution was such which would limit the powers of the king. So the day when the French king accepted the constitution drafted by the third estate, France converted from absolute monarchy to constitutional monarchy. Now the day when the king accepted the National Assembly, it means National Assembly got the power. It was like the parliament, and the parliament can make laws. So 4th of August, yes, Parliament can make laws. On the 4th of August, 1789, National Assembly took some decisions, important decisions. First, feudal system of obligation and taxes were abolished. What is the feudal system of obligation and taxes? Common people had to work free of cost for the nobles as and when the nobles called them. And when nobles called them, they had to go. If they did not go, they would be punished for not going. And the common people also had to give taxes to the state and church and to nobles also. So National Assembly cancelled all that. Nobles will not forcibly call the common people to work on the field. It would be optional for the people. And if the people come, they must be paid for that. And people would not pay any more tax to any noble now. They'll give only tax to the state, like income tax, direct tax. Now clergy. All the privileges, clergy have to give away their all the privileges. The most important privilege was they were exempted from the tax. And that privilege taking away, it means the clergy will have to pay the taxes. Plus, clergy also had power to collect a tithe. That tithe was also abolished. Now, clergy could not demand tithe from the common people. And whatever land churches had, all the land were confiscated by the National Assembly, that is, confiscated by the government. The value of the land was such that suddenly overnight the National Assembly got the property of 2 billion livres. The French government had the loan of 3 billion livres, and property worth 2 billion livres was acquired overnight by confiscating the land of the churches. So this is how the revolution took place, and the France has become constitutional monarchy from absolute monarchy. The history, the story of France doesn't get over. There are again some more videos, we'll see later. But if you like this video, please like and subscribe it, because this motivates me. And more I'm motivated, I promise you I'll make even more videos and more interesting and more explanatory videos. So motivate me by your likes and subscription. A bell, if you wish to press bell icon. Because if you press, you will be benefited. Because as and when I upload new video, you'll come to know. And you need not to come and check again and again. So please, it's my request to motivate me by liking and subscribing my video. Thank you so much. See you next video now.